I think the best way to understand Donald Trump is to read a book written by one of his daughters. And I tried to get Tiffany's book. Are you there, Dad? It's me, Tiffany. But nobody would publish it. So the only choice I had left was to pick up Ivanka's new book, Women Who Work. Full disclosure, I'm a woman who actually works, so I didn't have time to read the book. But I couldn't put down the reviews. According to the New Yorker, Ivanka Trump wrote a painfully oblivious book for basically no one. Then they went on to say, the book is mostly composed of artless jargon and inspirational quotes you might find by Googling inspirational quotes. The New York Times said, it reads like the scrambled Tumblr feed of a demented 12-year-old. And Jessica on Amazon said, this is literally the most insipid book I've ever read. For the life of me, I can't figure out who the audience of this book is. That's a great point, Jessica on Amazon. She got me thinking, who is this book for? And my theory is that Ivanka cut and pasted this opus together for her daddy. Because nobody on the planet needs this useless collection of gibberish more than that fat clown. For instance, on page 109, Ivanka writes, don't leave early or take time off. Too late. On page 124, Ivanka suggests picking up a hobby like calligraphy. That way, when you hand out secrets to the Russians, they look really pretty. On page 131, she writes, tip the scale. Looks like somebody already read that chapter. twice. And then ate it. And this last chapter is probably the most important one for Donald. Page 109 says, resign gracefully. She goes on to say, hasty exits are seldom looked upon well. The only exception is if you are in a position where you have access to secure information or your presence could create a conflict of interest. In that case, leave immediately. Once you've decided to quit, you must first tell your immediate boss. Not that one. Nope, not that one either. You're getting warmer. Warmer. And here to defend her book is the author herself, Ivanka Trump. Okay, hi. Thank you for coming. I know we don't have a good history together.
We do not.
Okay. So I was looking through your book. I mean, I didn't want to pay for it, obviously, because I didn't want to spend money on this.
Oh.
I was wondering, what is your favorite part about being Jewish?
So the bagels, for sure. They're like little Jewish donuts. You just put, you know, cream cheese schmear, as we call them, in the Jewish community, because I'm Jewish.
So I was curious how you had time to write this book because, I mean, you're so busy being your father's unpaid assistant and you are, like, always at the White House and you're always, you know, trying to act like you're doing things for women. I mean, when do you have time to write?
Well, full disclosure, I didn't write it. Barron wrote it. It was his homework assignment. I was like, that's good. I'll take it.
And so let's talk about, like, you know, your father and his, like, history with sexual improprieties, let's call them. You know, like, pussy grabbing.
Ooh.
And, like, how do you deal with that as a woman? Because I know you want women to be protected in the workplace,
oh,
right?
Oh, I am a feminist. I am a feminist. All you women out there, buy my shoes. Show them you're a feminist. They're in retailers everywhere. Fuck you, Nordstrom. My dad loves women. He puts them first. He touches them to let them know they're safe.
Yeah. I didn't even think of it that way. Thank you.
That's what he's doing. He's making women great again.
And what about, like, this healthcare bill? You know, I mean, there's, like, a lot of stuff in there that's really not, like, good for women. You know, like, if you get an STD from a rape, that's considered a pre-existing condition. How do you sleep at night?
Pass.
Oh. Oh, okay. Okay. Is there anything that I missed that you want to cover? Oh, I have an idea.
Okay.
Do you think when your father gets to prison, he'll take a fourth wife? Like a prison wife?
My dad will do whatever he wants. He's a great man, and anyone who doesn't think that is sad. They're a loser. Hashtag, I feel sorry for them. Hashtag, MAGA.
What is that, MAGA?
Make America Great Again.
Liberals. Good. Guys, liberals.
Well, I want to thank you for being here. You look fantastic,
as always. I appreciate that. Would you like me to sign your book?
Not really. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, hello. You caught me here in the middle of my own talk show, talking on my show. I hope you enjoyed whatever video of mine you just watched. I know I did. If you want to see more, you can click on that subscribe button, which is, I don't know where it is, but find a button and then click on it, and then just keep clicking, and then suck on that. Okay. Oh, hello.